Hello, astronomers! Today I'm really happy to tell to you about something that's very important to me, at a personal level. You know, my journey into astrophotography started a long time ago, when I was just 17. Back then, telescopes were much harder to find. There weren't many models available. And the ones that existed were expensive, really expensive. But I was already fascinated by the night sky, and I was determined to find a way to explore it. When I first began capturing images, it wasn't anything like today, really. I was using film cameras, yes, real film. You had to try your best to get the focus and exposure right blindly. Take a photo and then wait days to develop the film, only to discover that most of the images were either unexposed, overexposed, or had star trails from imperfect tracking. It was frustrating and very, very slow, but it taught me patience, and it deepened my love for the challenge. Then everything changed. Digital cameras arrived, and with them a revolution in astrophotography. Suddenly, we could see what we were doing in real time. We could adjust, tweak, improve, and slowly those beautiful images of the cosmos started to take shape on the screen. It was like the universe had become a little more reachable. And that's when I realized that astrophotography wasn't just a hobby. It was a way to experience the universe. It was a way to share that feeling with others, whether it's students seeing Saturn's rings for the first time, teachers looking for new ways to engage their classes, or amateur astronomers chasing the perfect shot. Astrophotography connects us. But when I first started in astrophotography, the learning curve was steep, really steep. I remember struggling to make all the different pieces of the telescope work together. The camera, the mount, the focuser, cables, so many of them. There were manuals for each device, and often they didn't speak the same language, literally. So I thought, what if there was one resource that could guide people step by step? Not just technically, but in a way that inspires curiosity and makes astrophotography approachable. That's why I wrote this book, and that's why I'm so happy to introduce you to the second edition of Explore the Universe Through Astrophotography, Capturing Pictures with Telescopes and PLAY Software. And that brings me to PLAY Software itself. PLAY stands for Prima Luce Astrophotography, and it was born from a very clear vision we had at PrimaLuceLab to make astrophotography easier and more accessible, also for those who are just starting out. We wanted to create a simple yet powerful control software that could bring together all the essential functions you need to take great pictures of the universe. Unlike closed systems like smart telescopes, that limit your ability to grow because they don't allow you to learn how to make astrophotography and because they don't allow you to select the mount and camera you want to use. PLAY is a great way to start in astrophotography without overwhelming you with too many settings or complicated workflows. Then, when you will learn the basics, you will be able to start using other great softwares without being forced to change your telescope. So let me be clear again. PLAY isn't here to replace amazing astrophotography softwares like Nina or Sequence Generator Pro. We love those tools, and we fully support them. They work great with our hardware, especially when paired with the Eagle computer. PLAY just offers an alternative, a simple path, especially for those who want a streamlined experience without sacrificing the power of automation. Originally, I actually began writing this book as a simple user manual for PLAY, a way to explain how to use the software step by step, especially for those new to the world of astrophotography. But as I was writing, I realized something. I wasn't just describing software. I was sharing what I had learned over 30 years of hands-on experience as an astrophotographer. So the book started to grow. I found myself adding not just technical explanations, but personal suggestions, insight, and little tricks that I had picked up over decades under the stars. Because astrophotography isn't just something I know, it's something I love. Of course, I enjoy the beauty of the night sky through an eyepiece. There's something magical about seeing Saturn's rings or the moon's crater with your own eyes. But what really pulls me in is astrophotography. Because astrophotography brings the universe to life. It reveals colors, structures, and faint details that the human eye simply can't see. And the incredible thing is that with the right tools, even a compact and portable telescope can capture stunning images of deep sky objects. You just need the right setup, a bit of guidance, and the passion to learn. But here's the thing. Astrophotography is also one of the most challenging things you can do with a telescope. It pushes your gear and your passions to the limit. You are dealing with long exposure, precise automation, precise tracking, weather, software, calibration. There is a lot that can go wrong. I've faced all those challenges, but I like the challenge. It's what drives innovation. It's what led me to create products at PrimaLuceLab. And it's what inspired me to turn this book into a more than just a manual, into a complete guide and companion for anyone who wants to take on the challenge and reveal the invisible wonders of the cosmos. Now, let me guide you through a quick tour of what's inside the second edition of my book. So chapter 1 dives into all the essential gears, telescopes, mounts, cameras, focusers, filters, rotators, and more. If you are just starting out, this is your roadmap. Chapter 2 explores the two big branches of astrophotography, planetary lunar and deep sky. I walk you through how they are different, what they require, and how to get started. Chapter 3 is one of my favorites. It's about what deep sky object you can photograph during each season of the year. Spring galaxies, summer nebulas, it's like an observing calendar. Chapter 4 is your step-by-step guide to setting up your telescope properly. This is the part I wish I had when I started. Chapter 5 and 6 go deep into how to use Play software. Not just the basics, but the advanced features like autofocus, auto-stacking, auto-alignment, tools that make life so much easier. Chapter 7 to 10 round it all with planetary imaging, full observatory control, and using third-party software with Play. So, this isn't just a book with pretty pictures. It's designed to be useful. And the best part, you can download the entire PDF version of the book for free right now. You find it on our website at www.primalucelab.com, or you can access it directly through the Play software. We wanted to make this knowledge as accessible as possible, because astrophotography should be open to everybody. Of course, if you love having a physical copy like I do, with beautiful high-resolution images, a hardcover finish, and something you can take with you to your observatory or telescope, you can also order the printed version from our website or from one of our dealers worldwide. I leave you with this. Astrophotography is both a science and an art. It's technical, yes, but it's also deeply emotional. Every image you take is a story. A challenge, a little slice of the universe you can capture. This book is my way of sharing what I've learned through years of observing, testing, designing, failing, and succeeding. It's for all of you who looked up and feel that same sense of wonder. So download the book, try Play, get under the stars, and explore the universe. And as usual, For more content that we help you to explore the universe like a pro, subscribe to our channel and clear skies!